The chairperson of Arua Taxi Park, Idi Yasin, says some people who claim to be landlords have been collecting huge money from the vendors. He says instead of the city collecting the revenue directly, the so-called landlords collect money and remit to the city.
These houses you are seeing are for government. This is a government facility. There are some specific people in the city who have given out this to other people. They call them landlords now. So those landlords, they have again given these houses to now the current people who are operating here. So it means the government rate which these people are supposed to pay to the government is 300. For down, then up is supposed to be 150. But they are charging 500 to 700, up to 800 per person. Sometimes also, after giving this money, a person can give you the rent money, but you don't deposit in the government account. That one causes also a revenue leakage to the government.
Instead of charging the normal government rate of ceilings 300,000 for the ground floor lockups and ceilings 150,000 for the upper lockups, the vendors are duped to pay from ceilings 500,000 to 800,000. The excess money is not remitted to the government coffers, causing revenue leakage to the city authority. Yasin says some of the business people are forced to pay twice.
One person can pay the rent for this house twice. You come, I give you the money. We expect you to go and deposit the money because you're already the landlord. I don't know the government because the person who have given me the lockup is you. So I give you the money, you put in your pocket. You don't reach to the government office. And more so, when we raise this complaint, we expect the town clerk to intervene. They all keep quiet. And then we said, okay, if it is like this, most of you have your rooms here. That's why you don't want to interact with us. Until the new town clerk came. And again, these people also keep on threatening the tenants.
It happened that the mayor instructed us to all pay to the account of the central division. So when I went there, I tried to ask the person who was sitting on the desk, the finance person, check the amount and the month which has been paid in the account, because I'm not the one paying. So when they checked, they found that the room that I paid even up this month was in areas of 3 months. I paid July, I paid June, I paid May. But when I went there, those months were not indicated. That means that money was not paid. 600 is per month, that means 1.8. The central division asked all the people who operate here to pay in their accounts, not giving money to somebody.
Rasid Osino, the councillor for Bazaar Ward where the taxi park is located, says the central division has lost huge sums of money to the wrong hands.
Who were here before, they were given 2 years to finish up their contract, and their contracts ended up in between this year. That's why we extensively have come up on board to control the facility. I hear, that's why you see the tenants have resorted with broad practices that you now go back and pay the division council so that we remit the 50% to the city. We also wait for their remittance downwards. That's the process, and I want to thank them. They have happily done it, and we are so proud of them, and we are now looking forward to offer them services.
How much is collected from rentals from the taxi park, because there's a code can clearly show that we have collected 100 million or 200 million in a quarter or in a month. Then there you'll be able to see the allocation formula comes automatic. Ndani, how it has been handled.
The Market Act 2023 Section 2B clearly stipulates that the central division manages the market and taxi park revenue collections. Arua Taxi Park was constructed in December 2018 with funding from Uganda's Support to Municipal Infrastructural Development, USMID, at the tune of ceilings 28 billion. Robert Ariaka reporting for Urban News in Arua, West Nile region.